So to the students, today we just recall all the number system. So please try to recall with me. First of all, natural numbers starts from 1, 2, dash, 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 n. Then whole number starts from 0, 1, 2, dash, 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 n. Then integers, all the numbers on the number line. Then rational numbers, the numbers in the form of p by q, comma q not equal to 0. P, Q belongs to I. Irrational numbers, all the non-terminating and non-recurring type numbers. Even numbers like 2, 4, 6, dash, dash, dash. Odd numbers, 1, 3, 5, dash, dash, dash. Complete square numbers, 1, 4, 9, dash, dash, dash. Prime numbers, all the algebraic concepts and all the geometric concepts. So now let us watch a video and note down your observations particularly.
Thank you. So we can't place these cards in any of these boxes.
So now question arises that can you guess why the girls are not able to place the cards like 2x square equal to 7, root 2, comma root 3 plus root 2 in any specified box. So now consider some collections around us. So there are many collections around us. Now try to refer all the collections from the PPT and try to note your observations. That is, can we find, we found some difficulty to collect the informations of the objects? In which collections we found difficulty to collect the informations of the objects? And now we conclude that, so these collections, out of these 12 collections, in some collections we can collect the information properly and in some collections we can't get the information properly. Means that is the difference of the well-defined collection and not well-defined collection. Now we study some collections and we conclude that some are well-defined and some are not well-defined. What is the collection of well-defined objects? That is called a set. Means we define set as a collection of well-defined objects. Sets are generally denoted by capital alphabets. They are enclosed in curly brackets. While writing the sets, we followed some rules, like the elements are not repeated in the set, elements are separated by commas, the sequence of the element is not important. So we consider an example for meaning of belongs to and not belongs to. Consider a set A equal to set of natural numbers up to 5. So here 1 belongs to capital A, comma dash 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 5 belongs to capital A. Means 1 to 5 are the elements of the set A, but 6 does not belongs to A. That is, 6 is not the element of the set A. So next point, methods to explain the sets. First, list or roster method. Second, rule or set builder form. So now consider list method. In the list method, the elements are listed only. So in the rule method, we explain the same set as A equal to X such that X belongs to capital N, comma X less than 11. Someone can say A equal to X such that X belongs to capital N, X less than or equal to 10. So here we try to generalize X. So make a question for X. Who are you and how are you? That is a question for X. That who are you and how are you, and that X tells us the solution. So that solution is nothing but the rule method. Now we discuss some intervals. Intervals are nothing but method to explain the sets in the list method or the set builder form. So let us consider a number line. So there are positive numbers on the RHS side and there are negative numbers on the LHS side. So we try to consider the example and try to understand the example first. That is, X less than 2 means what? Consider all the numbers from negative up to 2 except 2. Now X less than or equal to 2. So now consider all the numbers from negative up to 2 and with including 2. Same, X greater than 2 means what? What is the difference between X greater than 2 and X greater than or equal to 2? So in X greater than 2, we consider all the numbers which are larger than 2, and in X greater than or equal to 2, we consider all the numbers which are larger than 2 also with 2. Next, in the square bracket A comma B, in the square bracket A comma B equal to X such that x belongs to R, a less than or equal to x less than or equal to b. In the open bracket a comma b equal to x such that x less than a less than x less than b. Next bracket again a comma b x such that x belongs to R, a less than x less than or equal to b. In the open brackets infinity to a comma a to infinity etc. the different types of the intervals which are very useful while writing the sets. Types of sets. First, null oblique empty or void set does not contain any element called a null set. Example, n equal to x such that x belongs to capital N comma x less than 1. Singleton set which contains only one element. Example, n equal to x such that x belongs to capital N, x less than or equal to 1. Finite oblique infinite set, the set contains the elements are countable oblique uncountable respectively. Order of sets or cardinal element of the set. So consider the example, a equal to x such that x belongs to I comma minus 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2. So here we want to explain the set in the list method, that is equal to minus 2 minus 1 0 1 2. So here there are total 5 elements in the set, so therefore number of a equal to 5, that is called the cardinal element or the number of elements in the set. Equal sets. Consider the example, a equal to small a comma b comma c comma b equal to small b comma c comma a. So here number of a equal to number of b, and again all the elements are equal, so hence these two sets are equal sets. Next, equivalent sets. So consider the another example, a equal to set small a comma b comma c b equal to l m n. So here number of a equal to number of b, but all the elements are not same, hence these sets are called equivalent sets. So question first, what is the difference between the equal and equivalent sets? Question 2, join the pairs. So check from the PPT and try to join the pairs. Subset, proper and improper subset. So let us consider the example for this also. P equal to the set 1, 2, 6, 7. Q equal to set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. R equal to set x such that x belongs to N and x less than 10. S equal to set a comma b comma c. So here P is a subset of R. So check the symbol. P is a subset of R, that is called a proper subset because all the elements of P are lies in R. Q is a improper subset of R because all the elements are Q, R lies in R, also the all elements are equal. So proper subset and improper subset. Proper subset means all the elements of the first set lies in the second set. Improper means all the elements in both the sets are equal. Also R is called a superset of P and Q. S is not a subset of R because no element of S contained in R. Universal set. So what is meant by the universal set? In case of the number systems, capital N is a subset of W, is a subset of I, is a subset of Q, is a subset of R. So here capital R is the largest set among these all the sets. Means all the elements of N, W, I, Q are lies in R. So in this case we say capital R is the set which is called a universal set, and that is denoted by capital U or capital X. So now we try to study the algebra of sets, that is first union of the two sets. So union of two sets means A union B equal to X such that X belongs to A or oblique and X belongs to B. So while writing the union of the two sets, we consider all the elements from both the sets. Next, intersection of the two sets. A intersection B equal to X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. So in intersection we consider only the common elements from both the sets. Difference of the two sets A minus B equal to X such that X belongs to A and X does not belongs to B. This also can be written as A complement intersection B. B minus A equal to X such that X does not belongs to A and X belongs to B. This also can be written as A intersection B complement. Disjoint sets A intersection B equal to phi means there is no common element between the two sets A and B. So now let us try to study these all the concepts from the Venn diagram. So let us check the Venn diagram from the PPT. Let us consider the relation of the three sets now. So again check from the PPT. Check each and every part that shows like A intersection B intersection C, A intersection B intersection C complement, etc. So again consider the some examples and try to solve the examples by reading them properly. First example. So read the example properly and try to explain what are the givens in the examples and try to make the symbolic forms in case of the sets for each and every case. So now read the second example. Try to read the example properly. Try to understand what are the givens in the example and try to explain the symbolic form for the example and explain by using the Venn diagrams.